We want to solve the equation inverse cosine of x equals inverse sine of negative 5/13. So to solve this for x, we first want to isolate x. So to undo inverse cosine, we can take the cosine of both sides of the equation. So looking at the right side, remember the cosine function and the inverse cosine functions are inverses of one another, so these two functions undo each other, leaving us with just x on the left side of the equation. And then on the right side, we have just the cosine of inverse sine of negative 5/13. So looking at the right side of the equation here, we'll start with the inner inverse trig function. Inverse sine of negative 5/13 is equal to some angle theta such that sine theta is equal to negative 5/13, but also the output or range for the inverse sine function is the closed interval from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. So theta must be in the closed interval from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2, or the closed interval from negative 9 degrees to positive 9 degrees. So this angle theta must be in the first quadrant or the fourth quadrant. And since the sine function value is negative 5/13, the angle must terminate in the fourth quadrant. So let's go ahead and model this angle. Let's go ahead and assume it's this angle here. So if we sketch a reference triangle, we can label the opposite side negative 5, and the hypotenuse 13. Remember, sine theta is equal to the ratio of the length of the opposite side to the hypotenuse. Going back over to our equation now, if all of this is equal to theta, we can rewrite x as x equals cosine theta. And now we can use our reference triangle to determine cosine theta. Of course, we're missing the adjacent side of the reference triangle, so we'll have to use the Pythagorean theorem to determine the length of this side. But if we know our Pythagorean triples, we know this is going to be a 5, 12, 13 right triangle. If we didn't know that, we could label this x and then use the Pythagorean theorem to determine that value. And just to show that, we would have x squared plus negative 5 squared equals 13 squared, or x squared plus 25 equals 169. X squared subtract 25 on both sides equals 144, square root both sides. We know x is positive because we're in the fourth quadrant, so x equals 12. So now the cosine of angle theta would just be the ratio of the length of the adjacent side to the hypotenuse, or 12/13. So x is equal to 12/13, which would be the solution to the given equation. Key to doing this type of equation is recognizing that inverse sine of negative 5/13 represents an angle with a sine function value of negative 5/13, and that the angle must be in this specific interval. Once we do this, we can model the angle and the reference triangle and then solve for x. I hope you found this helpful.